Hi, everybody. Welcome to day. I appreciate that. Welcome to day number two of the Boss Lady Business Bootcamp. Thank you so much for tuning in. I really appreciate you. Thank you for the hearts. Keep them coming. While we're waiting for more people to join, go ahead and share this link with your friends, other entrepreneurs who you know of who may want to also take it up a notch as well. So thank you so much for everybody tuning in. My name is, excuse me for a second while I adjust here. All right. Enough of that. All right. How's everybody doing tonight? Go ahead and shout out below your business. I'd love to know more about what you're doing. And if you don't have a business, go ahead and shout out what you'd like to do. I'm sure you have an idea of some. I look a little tilted. Sorry here. Okay. Is that better? Okay. So, please go ahead and shout out tonight. Let me back up. Tonight is a working night. Again, as I said last night on day one, this is a boot camp about tangible, getting you to tangible results and getting you from an idea that you dreamt about or an idea that you know will work, but you've done nothing on. So this will get you from make-believe to reality, from idea to a tangible result. So my name is Teresa Campbell. I am the owner of Be Next Entertainment, and I have a real passion for helping people build dream businesses, helping people take an idea from nothing and making it something. In addition to that, I do enjoy helping walk people through spiritual issues, any blocks or obstacles that you have that may prevent you from living your life full out and may prevent you from having that dream business. So it's what I do, it's what I enjoy. And again, my name is Teresa. You can find me currently at www.benextentertainment.com. So again, thank you so much for watching. If you are watching, go ahead and give me thumbs up, hearts, all of that good stuff. I love it. And if you would be so inclined, go ahead and share this link on your Facebook page or, like I said, with friends and family that you know of who may be interested in something like this. This is the Boss Lady Business Bootcamp, and people ask me, well, you think you're really a boss? Why do you call it Boss Lady Business? And for me, Boss Lady simply means if you are taking care of your bills, if you are taking care of your family, if you're going to work and working 10 hours and coming home and washing clothes and cooking dinner and doing all of those things, if you have a business and you're doing your best to make that business grow, I consider you a boss. If you are making things happen and not whining and complaining, I consider you a boss. So that's what this is about. Tonight, and for those who are just tuning in for the first time tonight, Boss Lady Business Bootcamp will stand for Boss, B, Bridging the Gap, O, Organization, really having everything in order, your papers, your registration forms, your documents, all of those things that you really need to carry your business out in a professional manner. S will stand for systems, making sure that you're using the right systems and software and apps to really handle your business in a professional way. And the last will be your launch and really launching in a professional manner and in a manner that really gets people engaged. So that will take us through strategy. So the last one will be strategy. How do you launch in a decent way where you don't break your bank, but you are getting people to buy your product? So that's what the boss will stand for in this series, and we will carry this out for 10 days. So tonight we're going to talk about bridging the gap. And first, I want you to really consider what you are manifesting in your life. I want you to really consider the situations that show up in your life. And for me, it was a challenge to really accept that what was showing up in my life and what was manifesting in my life was a matter of my thought process. Again, up to my awakening, I really blamed everybody else, to be honest. It was either the man or the job or the boss or the car or the husband or the boyfriend or any other situation outside of me. And when I really stopped and did a gut check and a reality check and really got a hold of some great books, and read a lot of great high vibrational thinkers out there, I learned that really what was showing up in my life and what was manifesting for me, the reason why I didn't have a business and the reason why I didn't have relationships that I could be proud of, was because my thoughts were just not where they should have been, right? To be honest, my thoughts were crappy. So I read, just so you know, and if you are watching, please take note of this. I read a lot. I read Everything, excuse me, by Wayne Dyer. I read every tape, every audiobook, every book that he wrote, Wayne Dyer, and the last name is Dyer. I listened to everything Tony Robbins. I listened to everything Tony Robbins. Every audiobook, and this was at a time when you could go to the library, check out audio tapes if you remember those great things. And I really just allowed myself to be open to new information. And I got to a point in my life where I thought, what's the worst thing that can happen? You know, I'm working in this job. I love it, but I hate it. Can you relate to that? You're in a love-hate relationship with something, and you know you can do more. And I always knew, and whether it be better or not is not really the point I want you to come away with. Is it what you really want to do? And I knew that even though I had a great job, and you know, I'll just leave it at that. I had a great job. I really was wanting something different, and I really was wanting something more. And no disrespect to where I was, I just knew, even in my gut from a child, that I was called to something different. I was called to something that could really help people. And for so many years, I denied that. And it was a long process. It probably took me about 3 years, but I just began to really allow myself to drop old thinking, right? I grew up in the South and I lived a little bit in Compton, so I had some hang-ups. We'll just say that. I had some things that I had to let go of in order to really get to this place of, you know, can I believe something else in order to get me to this thing in my gut, in my soul, that would not go away? I mean, if you can relate to that, please let me know. I'm not talking gibberish. And drop a comment below. Say, I hear you, Teresa. I feel you, Teresa. I understand that, Teresa. I can relate to that, Teresa. You know, let me know. If I'm the only person who felt this way, then I should be on an island, right? I really got to a point where I had nothing else to lose. I had to really think differently. If you can imagine, you know, long white dresses below the knee, Holy Ghost praying, I could probably lay hands on some of y'all, and really getting to a point where you think, is there something more? Is there something else? And what really changed for me is understanding that we do vibrate. We are energy. We are not these bodies. I am not this hair, this dress, this necklace. I am really protons, electrons, neutrons vibrating. And every time that I interact with somebody else, I vibrate, and that energy, whether it be a low energy or a high energy, that energy transmutes to you. So I realized that as I walked the face of the earth, that I was changing the energy around me, whether I liked it or not. So if my thought process was, everybody is against me, nobody likes me, this job is holding me back, then everything that was showing up in my life was that. A lot of holding back, a lot of everybody else's fault and not mine. And I started just to question every thought that I had. So thank you so much for tuning. Hey, Brittany, I see you. Sorry to call out names, but hey, I get so excited. My apologies. And Mauricia, my cousin, I love you to death. Thank you so much for taking time out and being here. And my sister, Kathy, you better go ahead and drop some comments below. I wait on them every night. And all my family, I love and appreciate you. I really do. And, my heart, honestly. So, at any rate, I began to question every thought. Is it true, Teresa, really, that your boss is holding you back? Is it true, Teresa, really, that you're stuck because you're divorced? Is it true, Teresa, really, that you can't have a business? Is it true that, you know, your money is funny? Let's just call it what it is. And you can't have a business. Is all of that true? And the last question I asked myself was, have I done everything? I mean, you could just stop with that question and ask yourself, have you done everything that you can do to live the life that you want, to have that, whatever it may be? I'm a businesswoman. I love business. So that's my focus. But it could be, if you want to run the marathon, have you done everything that you could do? If you want to have a better job, have you done everything that you can do to get a better job? And I'm not here to say leaving your job is the answer. As a matter of fact, for some of you, you need to stay until you can get to a level of comfortability and confidence in yourself to, with an idea that's tangible that people will pay you for, where you can say, all right, now I can leave. I'm not one of those who say leave your job. That's bananas. But what I will say is, are you doing everything that you can do to have a business, right? So this is as much about business and being a boss as it is about your mindset. Honestly, some of those thoughts that we think don't serve us. Okay, so day in and day out, here's the exercise. Ask yourself, is it true? Whatever you're thinking, can I go on in life this way without this person, without this? Everybody who knows me knows that for me, the catalyst for my change was my mother and her passing. And I thought, there's no way I could go on. There's no way I could live and walk on the face of this earth anymore. And I start to question myself. It was a hard question. Is it true? Is it true that I can't go on without my mother? Well, every day I woke up, okay? And when I got past that, I started to really delve into what now? And that brought me to the business. So that's that. I want you from throughout our next 9 days, when you come across any thought, be it a good thought or a negative thought, a good thought or a bad thought, positive or a negative thought, ask yourself, is it true? And if it's something that doesn't serve your higher purpose, if it's something that doesn't reach into your soul and make you vibrate higher, question it. Continue to question that thought until you get to an answer that you can be comfortable with. And I will tell you that during my walk and my transformation, I was a maniac. I read books on Einstein. I read as much as my brain could hold, right? So I read a lot of physics books. I learned about the electromagnetic field and how there's so much of what we don't see. And there's energy in that. I learned about how that affects us. I learned about our voice and our sound and how that affects us. And there's a lot of education that I had to do in myself to change my thought process. What I want to get into tonight is bridging the gap. If you have an idea, if you want to do something different, you want to go live in Budapest for a month, or you want to travel instead of go to work every day, maybe you want to travel for business. How do you get from an idea to something that's tangible for you that shows up in your life? So say you have a business idea, you had a brainstorming set, you know, something came. I'm going to take a break for a second. Here's what I do. For those that have tuned in, shout out to Felicia K. I am still enjoying the wonderful gift of chocolate red wine. I never have had it before. Actually, was offered chocolate wine before and would never have drank the stuff. But I have a bottle of Red Decadence, which is amazing. So cheers to everyone watching tonight. Please take a moment and enjoy while I have a little sip. Please, thank you. At any rate, still yummy, Felicia. I love it. It's still awesome. So, bridging the gap. You have an idea. How do you know if your idea is a great idea? You know, you may want to go into the cleaning business, buy a franchise, do marketing and branding. You may want to do something that's a little different in the marketplace. How do you know that your idea is a good one? So, I have five things that I want to share with you before we go tonight. Again, this is a working boot camp, if you will. This is something where I really want you to have takeaways and implement those takeaways to help really change your life, really move you forward. Again, I just want to recap for those who just tuned in. Some of the books and authors that I've read to really help me with my mindset, and mindset is really important for any change. I read Wayne Dyer, Tony Robbins. I also read a lot of Byron Katie, Byron Katie. And I've read The Four Agreements. You really should read that. That was probably one of the first books I read that really changed my life. Of course, The Secret, when it was very popular, it was something I probably watched every day, changed my life. And of course, The Bible. And A Course in Miracles, A Course in Miracles was something that really, once I got through a year of reading that book, I was done. I felt like I was ready to do whatever it was I was called to do. So how do you know your idea? You have an idea, you want to, say you want to work, you want to build a business while you're working, or you have a great idea and you're ready to roll with it and you have funding. First, ask yourself, does it solve a problem? Okay. Does it solve a problem? If there is a problem that affects you, your friends, your family, anybody else that you know, 9 times out of 10, that is a problem that will do pretty well in the marketplace. And chances are that if it bothers you, it bothers somebody else. So that is one way to tell if your idea is something that's going to make you some money. Does it solve a problem? Number two, will people pay for it? I mean, I've heard some crazy stories, and have you ever heard of someone who has a business idea and you think to yourself, man, I wish I thought of that. So there was this one guy I knew who was selling metal. He would pick up scrap metal and actually was selling it to China. and was making a lot of money. Well, who knew? So next time you see somebody picking up scrap metal, don't judge them. They could be making bank by selling to China. So basically, number two is, will people pay you for it? An idea, it's just an idea if nobody's gonna pay you for it. So test the marketplace, do a lot of research. I mean, before I got into doing what I'm doing, I did a lot of research. And is there a sizable niche market for it? You know, if there are two people, those two people better have a lot of money who will pay you for your product. Make sure that you have a large market. What we will get into over the next 9 days also is how to sell to that market. That's probably the most important part of all of this. But tonight, number three of how do you know that your idea is a great idea? Is there a sizable market for it? Number four, are you passionate enough about it? And here's what I'll say about that. Having a business is not easy. You work a lot of hours, a lot of days, probably before you even see a return. So you have got to be really passionate, like have an undying spirit, a lot of energy to do this. And if you're doing it because someone else said do it, or it's not really something that's inside of you that you want to do, then I guarantee you, your energy will wane. So you need to have an idea that you are passionate about. It's something that wakes you up at night, makes you get out of the bed in the morning, and you can't think about anything else, right? So make sure that it's something that you're passionate about. And number five is to test your idea. Ask your friends, family again, does this sound like something that would work? And you can even, for those of you who are on social media, you know, maybe you can ask and send messages to a few of your friends. Hey, I have this idea. Does this sound good to you? Would you buy it? Is this something you would be interested in? So again, those are five ways to start to determine if your business idea is an idea that will work and that's tangible. I have more. There are at least 10 that I can walk you through that will help you know if your business idea is a good idea. And, you know, I hope that if it is a good idea, you'll take the next steps to really grow your business. So with that said, I've gone through quite a bit tonight. I hope you enjoy tonight. If you have any questions, that's what I wanted to say. If you have any questions, go ahead and drop your questions in the comment section. I'll definitely answer them. If there is something specific that you want me to address with regards to business, branding, marketing. Hey, Dawn! My favorite. I love you. Thank you for tuning in. Yes. is it true? Yes. So, anyway, thank you so much, everybody, for tuning in. Teresa, Be Next Entertainment. This is the Boss Lady Business Bootcamp. We will be back tomorrow for day three. And on day three, we're going to continue to talk about bridging the gap. We'll talk a little bit more about really organizing your thoughts and your idea. Again, this is specific to business. So if there's something else you want me to address, like if you want to, you know, go on a trip or travel around the world and you've never done anything like that before, if you want to go to Budapest and you don't know what to do there, or you're kind of scared of it, we can talk about anything here. Again, specifically is going to be about business. But I am open to, again, helping anybody change and really getting into the mindset of being different. Like, this is 2016. Come on. If you want more information about me, feel free to drop me a direct message. I'd love to get to know you, know more about you, and share the love. I am all about creating more relationships and friendships. So I enjoyed this. I look forward to really getting to know you better. And if you have any questions before we leave tonight, go ahead and drop your questions in the comment section. And I'm just going to scroll. Oh, God. I know. I should not touch it. Hey, you know what? For those of you who don't know, I told someone that I was from the South and they swore that I wasn't, that I lived in the South. And they were like, girl, get out of here. This timeline right here is proof that I'm from the South. So I love my family. I don't get to see them nearly as much as I want to, but I love all of you guys. And gosh, that was a surprise. I'm getting emotional. So I just have, we, and probably I'm getting emotional because we've come a long, long way, right? So for those of you who know me, you know that we've come a long, long way. I really appreciate your support. I really appreciate you being here with me tonight. I will be back tomorrow night, day three. We will continue to talk about bridging the gap, Boss Lady Business Boot Camp. Again, boss to me stands for anybody who is handling their business. Mother, corporate lady, business owner, anybody who's doing military, least I not forget my daughter for crying out loud, right? So you're just handling your stuff. So I consider you a boss. Okay, thank you very much. Join the crowd. At any rate, thank you so much for tuning in. I love you. I will see you tomorrow, day three, Boss Lady Business Boot Camp. This is Teresa signing out. Peace.